Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. From today onwards, I will upload videos for NEET exam. It is useful for those who are preparing NEET exam and also other entrance exam. So please continuously watch my videos and share my videos. This is my humble request. In this video, we see about some questions from the topic Winstone Bridge. I have already explained Winstone Bridge theory part. I give the video link in the description box. Please check that. Let's start. Question number 1. In the given circuit, current in the ohm BD is. Here one circuit is given. That circuit shows the Winstone Bridge arrangement. Okay, well, here we find the value of current in the ohm BD, or we can say that current in galvanometer. Okay, here your galvanometer is connected between B and D. Okay, in the given circuit shows the Winstone Bridge is a balanced one, and hence the current through BD is zero. That means if the Winstone Bridge is balanced, the galvanometer current is zero. So the current in the ohm BD is zero. So the answer is C. Okay, ma. Next question is, three resistance P, Q are each of 2 ohm. Okay, that is P value is 2 ohm, Q value is 2 ohm, then R value is 2 ohm, and an unknown resistance S form the 4 ohms of the Winstone Bridge circuit. Okay, so in the Winstone Bridge circuit, there are 4 ohms, P, Q, R and S, isn't it? So here P, Q, R value is 2 ohm, but we don't know the value of resistance S. Okay, so that is the unknown resistance S. Okay, when a resistance of 6 ohm is connected in parallel to S. Okay, so the resistance S is unknown value. Now we connect the 6 ohm resistance parallel to the unknown resistance S. Okay, so the bridge gets balanced. Then the question is, what is the value of S? Okay, so to explain this question, I draw one circuit diagram, that is Winstone Bridge circuit diagram, that is P, Q or S. Here in the questions, P, Q or value is 2 ohm. Okay, so 2 ohm, 2 ohm, 2 ohm, but S values we don't know, that is unknown value. Then 6 ohm, another 6 ohm resistance is connected to the S resistance. Okay, so I draw this circuit diagram. Now let X be the equivalent resistance of S and 6 ohm. Okay, so instead of S and 6 ohm, I write X. Draw the equivalent circuit P, Q, R and X. Okay, instead of S and 6 ohm, I put the value X. That is X means unknown. Okay, so I write the equation 1 by X equal to 1 by S plus 1 by 6. Okay, ma. Next, for a balanced Winstone Bridge. This is the condition for balanced Winstone Bridge is P by Q equal to R by X. Okay, ma. So here P, Q value is 2 and by 2. Okay, so P value is 2, Q value is 2, then R value is also 2, but X value we don't know. So we simply write X. From that we find the value of X equal to 2 ohm. Okay, so substitute this X value in the equation 1 by X equal to 1 by S plus 1 by 6. So we get 1 by 2 equal to 1 by S plus 1 by 6. Okay, ma. So we find the value of S value, isn't it? So 1 by S equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 6. That is, we rearrange the equation. Okay, so simplify the values, that is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 6, we get the value 2 by 6. Okay, so 2 by 6 means we get the answer 1 by 3. Okay, so 1 by s equal to 1 by 3. So we can write s equal to 3 ohm. Okay, so the answer is A. Next question is, in a Wheatstone plate, 3 resistors P, Q and R connected in the 3 ohms and the 4th ohm is formed by 2 resistors S1 and S2 connected in parallel. The condition for bridge to be balanced will be. Here, in the Wheatstone bridge arrangement, P and Q are connected. Okay, so 3 resistors are connected in 3 ohms. Then the 4th resistor S is split into 2 resistors, that is S equal to S1 plus S2. Okay, so that way we connected the resistance in parallel. Okay, so now what is, now we find the, what is the condition for bridge to be balanced. Okay, so here one condition is that the 4th ohms formed by 2 resistors, that is S1 and S2 connected in parallel. Okay, so now as per Wheatstone bridge, balanced, P by Q equal to R by S. This is the condition for bridge balanced. Okay, so P by Q equal to R by S. Here the resistance, the S resistance is split into 2 resistance. Okay, so we can write 1 by S equal to 1 by S1 plus 1 by S2. Okay, then 1 by S equal to, so we simplify 1 by S1 plus 1 by S2, we get we cross multiply. Okay, so cross multiply and rearrange, we get the value S1 plus S2 by S1 S2. Okay, so here then substitute the value of 1 by S in the bridge balanced condition equation, that is P by Q equal to R by S. So we get the answer P by Q equal to R into S1 plus S2 by S1 S2. So the answer is C. Okay, so that's all friends. Thank you.